Hi people, this is a quick response video to PMC Jewelry. He asked me about what kind of microscope is good for engraving. I am not a microscope expert, but you kind of pick up a few things, and I'll just point a few things to look at if you're looking for a second-hand microscope or a cheaper one that might be okay. The first thing to look for is the eyepieces. I don't understand what they all mean, but you'll see this is the ones that I use, which are WF, I can't even read that, right, 10, 20, whatever that means. And these are quite cheap. These are just Chinese ones because I had times 12 before and they were really good ones, but that's the thing to look for. Can you see the lens on the top, how wide it is? You'll see some and they're like a tiny little circle. They're no good because you see that amount of view through the scope. So that's what you got to look for. Even if it's a cheap one, you kind of, I don't know if I can see through there. Oh, you can see through, hang on. Anyway, can I demonstrate? Anyway, you imagine, so you see the full circle there. So if you, there's other ones like for microbes and all that, and they're tiny, so they just want to zoom in. The other thing to look for is you will need what's called a Barlow lens. I think it'll be referred to as a Barlow lens or some sort of objective, and there'll be numbers on the side, and this is the kind of standard one, which is 0.5. I'll explain what that does. It does a thing called increasing the working distance from the base, from what you're working. So there's the top of my vise with a coin in it, and that is in focus. And that distance, there's a bit of A4 paper, and that's the distance from there to the top of my scope, which is 21 centimeters. So if you don't have that off, it'll be about like half that, and it's slightly awkward to get your hand in. So look, I've got loads of room now, and I could, if I zoom in a bit, maybe this is fully zoomed out, maybe if I zoomed in it'd be slightly smaller. I think that's it really. So you just got to get that. There's a cheap one, I'll show you that. This is a cheap Chinese one, and it's pretty good. It's got the same kind of lenses, the wide ones. You can buy different ones of these. I've got a 0.3 Barlow lens, and it actually made the distance smaller. So just the cheap one and slightly less. Let me show you. I'll show you a light. You don't need an expensive light. So that is the distance with the cheap one. There's no brand on this. It's just you just have to look at it and see what you think, and you may need a different kind of setup. What you can do with these is turn that around, because you still got to work underneath it and put some kind of weight on this side. And that's all I know. The only way to get a good scope is if you're lucky and you get a second hand one, and there's a lot of things you can get mildew inside them and things like that. So if you're prepared to take a chance on a cheap one and clean it, or if you know a service that can do that. You also, I'll just mention, a turntable is very good for it. Right, that's basically it. When you buy a scope, you just kind of, you learn all about it. Then once you got one, you forget all about it. But that's the main things to look for. You'll need one of these, and you'll need wider lenses. And that 10 times 20 is the kind of okay. If it's anything else, it might not be the best thing. Hope that helps everybody. Cheers, bye.